service of prayers for pilgrims. We begin with a collect, the special prayer for St. David, who called others to be joyful, to keep the faith, and to be faithful in the little things of life. Let us pray. The collect for St. David. God our Father, you gave St. David to the people of Wales to uphold the faith. Encouraged by his example, may we joyfully hold fast to the things which lead to eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, your honour and glory, now and forever. Amen. A reading from Scripture, from the 16th chapter of the Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus taught his disciples, if any man would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. In this time of living with the coronavirus still in our midst, we have experienced many differences to our daily routine. Now we can, in small ways, exchange those restrictions for a time of relaxation or even a holiday. Believing that a holiday will help us to restore relationships, perhaps heal things that are damaged, but it may not be so. King David wrote in Psalm 32 about his struggle with himself and what had gone wrong, the things that had gone wrong in this life, and how he asked God for help. Only then he was able to rise above the things that held him down and to praise God for the deliverance that he had received. From Psalm 121, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. On our pilgrim journey, we have followed many who have travelled this way before, and many who will travel this way after us. This is a holy place, a place where we can find solace, where we can find an uplifting of all that is concerning us. For a moment, let us pause and consider our own journey of life. Where are we now? Where are we heading? What is the way ahead, shaped by God's good and loving purpose? In the journey to and fro, God direct us. In our happiness and pleasure, God bless us. In peril and in dangers, God protect us. Let us pray for ourselves and all who visit the cathedral today, that God will guide our lives. Lord Jesus Christ, St. David's Saviour and ours, you are the way, the truth and the life. Be our way. Give us grace to follow your lead. Courage to persevere when the going is tough. And when we stumble, let us not be afraid to grasp your outstretched hand as you offer us a fresh start. Be our truth. Give us your wisdom, so we may know how to walk in the paths of honesty and integrity. Be our life. Revive us when we falter. Refresh us when we tire. And bring us to share in your risen life, now and for all eternity. Amen. Please join me as we pray together the prayer that our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. How do you desire to go forward? Jesus Christ calls you to follow, promising his companionship, his guidance, his strength and love in whatever life brings. So our closing prayer. Almighty God, awaken in us the zeal of your servant David, that we may joyfully follow you in singleness of heart, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And Almighty God, awaken in us that zeal. May we show to our fellow men the love, the empathy and compassion that you have. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.